Okay, in performance parameter of the three-phase induction motor, first calculation of no load current, that is I0, is very important. In which first we have to calculate magnetizing current IM and core loss component, that is IL. Okay, that means in which no load current is measured from no load. Okay, then first we have to calculate magnetizing current. Okay, then in which we have to need calculation of magnetizing current, that is IM. Okay, then also the magnetizing current also depends on flux, and this flux which is provided by stator MMF turns. Okay, also these flux are passes through stator core, stator teeth, air gap, rotor teeth and rotor core. That means flux always passes from stator core, then rotor core, then stator teeth, then rotor teeth, and air gap between stator and rotor. That means these all parameters is very important in magnetizing current in three-phase induction. Okay, then also magnetizing current also depends on several parameters. That is, first point is MMF for air gap. The symbol of MMF for air gap is 18. Okay, that is MMF for air gap, that is 18. Also, in which the flux density concept is very important in air gap. Also, in which use interpolations. Okay, that means, for example, this is stator. Okay. Also, in which we have placed rotor. So then, this is the axis, vertical axis, this is the horizontal axis. Okay. And this is the 90 degree angle. Okay. Then, this is the 45 degree angle. Okay. Then, also, in which we have considered 60 degree angle in interpole axis. For example, we have considered this is the 45 degree. And then also this is the 60 degree angle. Okay, then in which this is the maximum angle in air gap. Okay, then at that instant we have to need to calculate flux density at 60 degree. Okay, now the air gap flux density at 60 degree, it gives average flux density in the form of 1.336 average flux density. That means the maximum flux density at 60 degrees 1.36 average flux density. At that instant the magnetic flux always present. Then we have to calculate magnetometer force, that is MMF for air gap. Now this is the standard formula, that is MMF for air gap is 8 lakh B into MMF for air gap at 60 degree kg into LG. That means kg means gap contraction factor, then LG means length of air gap, and B average means average flux density. That means MMF for air gap ATG is always depends on flux density and also average flux density, then length of air gap. Okay, now this is the first point is MMF for air gap under calculations of magnetizing. Okay, then second point is MMF for stator teeth. Okay, now this is the diagram of stator teeth. Okay, now this is the slot. Okay, now this is the slot and these are the teeth. Okay, then also in which we have taken the axis. Okay, then WSS means width of stator teeth. Okay, then this is the 1/3 height of the teeth of the stator. This is the 2/3 height of the stator teeth. Okay, now also MMF for stator teeth symbol is ATTS, that is stator teeth for ampere turns. Okay, then parallel sided teeth. These are the first teeth, second, and this is the third. Each and every teeth are parallel to each other. Then parallel sided teeth, in which flux density is uniform. Means in teeth flux density is uniform, but parallel sided slot. First, this is a slot. Okay, first, second, and third slot. Okay, then parallel sided slot. The flux density is non-uniform. That means upper side of the teeth flux density is uniform, and downward side flux density is non-uniform. This is the difference between flux density with respect to stator, teeth, and slot. Okay. Now, also in which we have to calculate flux density at 1 by 3. Okay, now we have to first calculate flux density at 1 by 3 ratio. That is, flux density at 1 by 3 height of the tooth from narrow. That means we have to calculate this section, that is 1 by 3 section. Okay. Then, that is stator teeth flux density at 1 by 3 is equal to 5m. 5m is maximum flux upon S into Li into WTS 1 by 3. Then WTS 1 by 3 means width of stator teeth or tooth at 1 by 3 height of the narrow end. That means this is the narrow end, and then in which we have to calculate stator teeth at 1 by 3. Okay. Then the formula for stator teeth is pi into bracket d plus 2 dss upon 3 upon ess minus ws. That means wss means width of stator slot. This is the width of stator slot always present. Then ss means stator slot, and dss means depth of stator slot, and capital means stator bore diameter. Okay. Now these four important parameters is very important in to find out width of stator teeth at 1 by 3 ratio. That means flux density at 1 by 3 is the height of tooth from narrow end. That means this is the formula for when we have considered 1 by 3 ratio. Okay. Now this is the standard formula is used to find out the stator width or width of stator tooth. Okay. Now this is the important formula for MMF for stator teeth. Okay. Then also in which we have to calculate magnetometer force for stator. Okay. Then we have first consider maximum angle is 60 degree. Then calculate stator teeth flux density is the 1 by 3 6 into BTS, that is stator teeth flux density. Then BTS means MMF for stator teeth with respect to flux density. Then WSS means width of stator slot. Then SS means stator slot. Then WTS means width of stator teeth. Okay. Then DSS means stator slot diameter or depth of stator slot. Okay. Now this is the important parameters and important symbols used in MMF for stator teeth. Okay. Now this is the second expression for MMF for stator teeth with respect to 1 by 3 ratio. Okay. Now this is the important formula for width of stator. Okay. This is the second part in magnetizing current. Then third part is MMF for rotor teeth. Then previous we have calculated MMF for stator teeth. Okay. Then also in which same procedure follow for MMF for rotor teeth, because in stator teeth we have considered 1 by 3 height of the ratio with respect to narrow end when using flux density. Okay. Same procedure also in which we have to calculate uniform flux density at rotor teeth. Okay. Then also consider flux density at 1 by 3 height from the narrow end. Same formula, that is BTR is 1 by 3, that is rotor teeth flux density or also called as rotor teeth MMF is equal to phi m upon SR upon P into LI into WTR 1 by. Okay, phi m means maximum flux, SR means number of bars, P means number of poles, LI means core length, then WTR means width of rotor ring. Okay, then same formula for stator tip as compared to rotor tip. Okay, that is WTR is equal to 1 by 3 pi into bracket dr minus 2 into 2 into dsr upon 3. Okay, now this is the important formula is to find out MMF for rotor tip. DSR means depth of rotor slot. Okay, then WSR means width of rotor slot. The same condition for flux density at 60 degree. Okay, now then also in which we have need to calculate MMF required for rotor B. Okay, then formula for MMF required for rotor teeth, ATTR is equal to ATTR into DS. DSR means depth of rotor slot, then ATTR means MMF for rotor. Okay, then also all parameter can be explained with the help of diagram, and this is the diagram for rotor. Okay, these are the rotor teeth. Okay, then also in which this is the DR means depth of rotor or diameter of the rotor. Then this is the 1 by 3 ratio. This is the 2 by 3 ratio. Okay. Red line also used for indication for ratio. Then also this is the difference or depth of stator rotor. This is the diameter of the rotor with respect to stator. Okay. Now this is the diagram of MMF for rotor tip. Also, the overall operation of the rotor teeth will be depends on slot and number of poles using induction motor. Okay. Now, this is the just overview of the MMF for rotor teeth. Okay. This is the standard formula for MMF for rotor teeth. Okay. This is the diagram also in which we have to show 1 by 3 ratio, 2 by 3 ratio with respect to stator and rotor. Okay. Then MMF for stator core, that is symbol is ATCS. Okay. Then MMF for stator core is depends on flux density, and also the find out the MMF for stator core with the help of BH curve. Okay. Then also we have to show the just diagram of the BH curve. Okay. Then formula for MMF for stator core is ATCS is equal to is depend on length of stator core. Okay, that is 1 by 3 pi into D plus 2 into DSS plus DCS upon P. Then DSS means depth of stator slot, then DCS means depth of stator core. Okay. Then length of stator core, LCS means length of stator core, then DSS means depth of stator slot. Okay, these symbols is very confusing because each and every part of the induction motor, because slot, then tooth, teeth, each and every part different symbol is with respect to stator and rotor. Then carefully the listen the all the symbols, because symbol is very important in performance parameter of the three-phase induction motor. Also, this is the stator core diameter, that is the external circle indicates for stator and internal circle indicates for rotor. This is the capital D means diameter of the rotor. Okay. Then DCS means depth of stator core. DCS means depth of stator core, and DSS means depth of stator slot. This is the formula for MMF for stator core, that is ATCS is equal to small ATCS into LCS, that is stator core MMF, then LCS means stator core length. Okay, now this is the formula for MMF for stator core. Okay, and then we have to calculate MMF for rotor core. Okay. Now this is the diagram of the rotor core. Now this is the only rotor core and this is for stator core. Okay, then in which length of flux path in rotor core, that is the called as LCR. LCR is equal to pi into bracket d minus 2 into dsr minus ecr upon 3p. P means number of holes. Dsr means rotor depth of rotor slot. Dcr means depth of rotor core. Okay. Symbol is very important for design of stator and rotor. Okay. Then also in which this is the dr means depth of rotor. If this is the only circle of the rotor, not including stator. Okay. Dsr means depth of rotor slot. Dcr means depth of rotor core. Okay. Now this is the diagram for MMF for rotor core. That is called as ATCR. Okay. Now this is the important formula. Then also in design of magnetizing current for stator and rotor core, then in which total magnetizing MMF is present with respect to, we have to consider angle is 60 degree. Okay. Then total magnetizing MMF at 60 degree is equal to ATG plus ATCS plus ATTR plus ATCS plus ATCR. ATG means MMF for air gap. Okay. ATG means MMF for air gap. ATG means MMF for air gap. Then ATCS means MMF for stator core. Okay. Then ATTR means MMF for rotor teeth. Okay. Then ATCS means MMF for stator core. Okay. Then ATCR means MMF for rotor core. Okay. Now in total magnetizing MMF, with respect to pole, we have to consider flux density with respect to angle is 60 degree, and then also in which we have to calculate all parameters of the magnetizing MMF. And these all parameters will be depends on several parameters of the then in which we have to consider all parameters of the MMF. Okay. Then in magnetizing MMF, we have to calculate all parameters with respect to stator and rotor. Okay. With respect to stator core and rotor core. Okay. Then rotor teeth and stator teeth. Okay. That means these six parameters is very important in to find out total magnetizing MMF. Okay. And also this is the formula for magnetizing current per phase present in 3-phase induction motor. Okay. That means IM is equal to 0.427. P means number of poles, 8060. That means this is the ampere turns per 60 degree. This value is put in here. Okay. And KW, S means winding factor, and TS means stator turns per phase, and P for number of poles. Now this is the magnetizing current for 3-phase induction motor. Okay. Then second parameter is remaining, that is core loss component. That means no load current is equal to I0 is equal to square root of IM square plus IL square. Okay, then first we have to calculate magnetizing current for 3-phase induction motor. Is calculated here. Okay, then calculate core loss component. Okay, now we have to need expression for core loss component. Okay, then core loss component symbol is IL. Okay, in core loss component, first we have to need iron loss. Okay. Then Core loss component is depends on hysteresis loss, then eddy current loss, then also in which we have to need the study of the surface loss. And this surface loss always present in teeth of the stator and rotor. Also in which we have to calculate pulsation loss, tooth pulsation loss, because tooth pulsation loss is depends on density, flux density. Then also in core loss component, we have to need to find out total loss. Then total loss is equal to weight, and weight measured in kilogram into specific iron loss, weight per kilogram. Now this is the formula for core loss component, that is loss is equal to weight in kilogram into specific iron loss. Also core loss component is also depends on friction losses and windage losses. Okay, now these are the several values of the friction and windage losses. Okay, then also friction loss and windage loss, their percentage output is shown in table. Okay, now we have considered output in kilowatt 0.75, then friction and windage loss with respect to percentage, that is 5.5, then output is 3.7, 3.5, then 7.5, 2.7, then 37, 1.5, 75, 1.2, then 150, 1.0. That means output increases, output in kilowatt increases, then value of the friction and windage loss is decreases. Okay. Now this is the main relation of the friction and windage loss with respect to power, power in the form of kilowatt. Okay. Then also in magnetizing current, first we have to find out, then this is the load current, that is total number of load losses upon 3 into voltage per phase. Now this is the second parameter in IL, that is no load current is equal to square root of IM square plus IL square. That means calculation of magnetizing current and core loss component is very important in 3-phase induction motor with respect to stator and rotor, with respect to stator teeth, rotor teeth, with respect to stator core and rotor core, then calculate total magnetizing MMF and then obtain the value of IM. Then we have to find out core loss component with respect to iron loss, friction loss and windage loss, and these three parameters will be depends on output, and output in the form of kilowatt. Then find out core loss component, that is IL. Okay.
Exactly, technical direction in the paper made it. Okay.
Okay, now this is the overview of the magnetizing current and core loss component. Okay, then also in which we have to need several parameters. Okay, then also performance parameter of the 3-phase induction motor is depends on saturation point. Okay, saturation point means maximum limit of the flux density. Okay, then also in effect of saturation region will be depends on MMF, that is magnetometer force, and magnetometer force we have to calculate with the help of stator and rotor. Okay, also this is the diagram of BH curve. Okay, then this is the B indicates for मैक्सिमम फ्लक्स डेंसिटी, एच मीन्स मैग्नेटिक फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द रेंज ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ, दैट इज 50, 100, 400. ओके, देन दिस इज द फ्लक्स डेंसिटी वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर, दैट इज 1.1, 1.3, 1.5. नाउ दिस इज द लाइन, बिलो लाइन इज कॉल्ड एज बिलो सैचुरेशन एंड अबव सैचुरेशन. ओके, देन इन बीएच कर्व, ओके, द फ्लक्स डेंसिटी इज 1.1 वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर. ऑल्सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज द फर्स्ट रेटिंग ऑफ द बीएच कर्व, इज फ्लक्स डेंसिटी इज 1.1 वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर. एट दैट इंस्टेंट इन विच द वैल्यू ऑफ द 1.1 एंड 1.3 द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ इज 50 to 100. फॉर बिलो सैचुरेशन एंड अबव सैचुरेशन द वैल्यू ऑफ फ्लक्स डेंसिटी इज 1.5 वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर एंड इट्स रेंज इज 400. ओके, दैट मीन्स अबव सैचुरेशन वी हैव टू रिक्वायर्ड मोर एमएमएम, दैट मीन्स अबव सैचुरेशन वी हैव टू रिक्वायर्ड मोर एमएमएम एंड बिलो सैचुरेशन वी हैव रिक्वायर्ड लेस एमएमएम. दिस इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन अबव सैचुरेशन एंड बिलो सैचुरेशन, दैट मीन्स अबव सैचुरेशन वी हैव टू नीड मैक्सिमम एमएमएम विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू फ्लक्स डेंसिटी इज 1.5 वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर एंड बिलो सैचुरेशन वी हैव टू नीड लो एमएमएम विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू 1.1 वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर टू 1.3 वेबर पर मीटर स्क्वायर. नाउ दिस इज द जस्ट ओवरव्यू ऑफ द सैचुरेशन पॉइंट इज डिपेंड्स ऑन फ्लक्स डेंसिटी एंड फ्लक्स डेंसिटी स्ट्रेंथ. ओके, दैट इज फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ. ओके, दैट इज दिस इज कॉल्ड एज बीएच कर्व. ओके, नाउ जस्ट दिस इज द ओवरव्यू ऑफ द इफेक्ट ऑफ सैचुरेशन इन इंडक्शन मोटर विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू हायर फ्लक्स डेंसिटी. ओके, ऑल्सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज इफेक्ट ऑफ डक्ट पोर्शन, इज द कॉल्ड एज एयर गैप बिटवीन स्टेटर एंड रोटर. ओके, इन इफेक्ट ऑफ डक्ट्स ऑन कैलकुलेशन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक करंट, दैट मीन्स इन एमएमएफ फॉर एयर गैप वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट मैग्नेटाइजिंग करंट. देन इन विच फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज एमएमएफ फॉर एयर गैप, दैट मीन्स मैग्नेटोमीटर फोर्स बिटवीन स्टेटर एंड रोटर. ओके, फॉर क्लोथ स्लॉट आयरन सरफेस, फॉर क्लोथ स्लॉट आयरन सरफेस ऑन द टू साइडेड ऑफ द एयर गैप आर स्मूथ. ओके, देन सो द फ्लक्स इज यूनिफॉर्मली स्प्रेड, दैट मीन्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल एमएमएफ ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट इन स्टेटर एंड रोटर. ओके, देन ऑल्सो टू साइडेड और टू साइड ऑफ द एयर गैप इज स्मूथ, फॉर एग्जाम्पल रोटर एंड स्टेटर. एट दैट इंस्टेंट वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट स्लॉट पिच एंड लेंथ ऑफ एयर गैप, बिकॉज स्लॉट ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट इन स्टेटर एंड रोटर, देन वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट स्लॉट पिच, दैट मीन डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू स्लॉट, एंड ऑल्सो फाइंड आउट लेंथ ऑफ एयर गैप. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज एमएमएफ फॉर एयर गैप. ओके, देन फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस आर द टू स्लॉट. ओके, दिस इज द एयर गैप. ओके, एंड दिस इज द स्लॉट पिच, वाई इज मीन्स स्लॉट पिच, ऑल्सो टूथ आर प्रेजेंट बिटवीन टू स्लॉट. ओके, एयर गैप सिंबल इज देयर, दैट इज लेंथ ऑफ एयर गैप, स्लॉट पिच, एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्लॉट, दिस इज सेकंड स्लॉट. ओके, देन ऑल्सो इन विच वी हैव कंसिडर ओनली वन स्लॉट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव कंसिडर ओनली वन स्लॉट. ओके, देन एट एट इंस्टेंट रिलक्टेंस ऑफ एयर गैप इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन दिस एयर गैप रिलक्टेंस ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट. नाउ दिस इज द एयर गैप एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्लॉट, दिस इज द सेकंड स्लॉट एंड टूथ ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट, देन एट एट इंस्टेंट वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट रिलक्टेंस, एंड दिस रिलक्टेंस ऑलवेज डिपेंड्स ऑन फ्लक्स. ओके, द फॉर्मूला फॉर रिलक्टेंस इन एयर गैप, एस जी इज इक्वल टू एल अपॉन म्यू जीरो इनटू ए, देन एल मींस लेंथ ऑफ एयर गैप, एस जी मींस रिलक्टेंस ऑफ एयर गैप. ओके, देन द फॉर्मूला फॉर एस जी इज इक्वल टू एल जी अपॉन म्यू जीरो इनटू एल इनटू वाई, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज इक्वेशन नंबर टू, दैट मींस रिलक्टेंस ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट इन एयर गैप व्हेन वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट वन स्लॉट पिच और वी हैव सिलेक्ट one slot. Okay. Now also these are the two slot are present. This is the first slot. This is the second slot. WT means width of two slot. That is WT. YS means slot pitch. Okay. Then length of air gap. Then the large amount of reluctance present in this side and small amount of reluctance present this side. Okay. Now these are the tooth. These are the teeth. This is the tooth. These are present. Okay. Then also this is the diagram in the form of dimension. That is the WS. That is width of slot. Width of slot. Then width of teeth or tooth. Okay. YS means slot pitch for this two section. And YS dash for this section. Okay. That means we have to find out slot pitch for two section. That is YS and YS dash. Okay. Then also in which we have to need to first calculate YS. Okay. YS dash is equal to, for example, YS dash is equal to WT. Okay. Then YS dash is equal to WT plus sigma into this half section taken. Okay. This half section are taken. That is half WS plus half WS. Then 2WS upon 2, then 2 to get cancelled. Okay. Then YS dash is equal to WT plus sigma S. This is the important formula for this section. That means we have to calculate slot pitch for this section. That is YS dash. Okay. Then also YS dash is equal to put WT. Okay. But also in which the YS dash is equal to YS minus 1 half WS plus 1 half WS. That means this is the first we have to calculate this section. Okay. Then also remaining section is present. Okay. Okay. That is WT is value is YS minus 1 half. For example, this is the positive section we have taken. Okay. And this is the negative section. Then WT is equal to YS minus 1 half. That is the, we have considered this section. That is half WS and half WS. Okay. That means YS minus 2WS upon 2. And we have to calculate YS dash is equal to YS minus WS. Then here 2 to get cancel. That is YS dash is equal to YS minus WS. Okay. Then also in which we have to calculate reluctance. Okay. I have already calculated reluctance is SG is equal to L upon mu 0 into A. Then SG is equal to LG upon mu 0 into LYS. Then we have to calculate YS dash because already YS is there. Okay. Then we have to calculate YS dash. Okay. Then put here YS dash value. That is put YS is equal to, that is YS dash. Then SG is equal to LG upon mu 0 into L into YS dash. Then also the value of YS dash is present here. Okay. And this value put here. Okay. That is YS dash. That is SG, that means reluctance in air gap is depends on length of air gap, that is LG upon mu 0 into L, that is total overall length into YS minus WS. YS means slot pitch and WS means width of slot. Now this is the important formula for reluctance in air gap with respect to slot and width. Okay. Now these are the important formulas for reluctance in gap. Okay. Then also in which we have to need their important parameters. Okay. Then, okay. Then just this is the important parameter like reluctance in air gap. This is the important. Also this diagram is very important to find out the slot between these two slot. Also we have to need reluctance concept for upside and downside. For upside, large reluctance present and downside, small reluctance is present. Okay. Now these two condition is very important. Then for half section, we have taken positive. Then another half section we have taken negative. Then find out the slot pitch, that is YS dash, and also we have taken the reluctance of here. Okay. Okay, then also we have to calculate YS dash is equal to WT plus sigma W. This expression also shown here, that is YS dash is equal to WT plus sigma into half WS half W, that is twice WS upon 2, that is W2 WT plus sigma W, that is here 2 to get cancelled. Okay, then obtain YS dash is equal to WT plus sigma WS. Okay, then also in this section WT and sigma WS, this is the positive side WS, because this in which for example this is the tooth. Okay, we have shown. Okay, this is the cross section. Okay, then in this is the half side WS, this is the half side WS. That means in which present WS from this side and WS from this side. Okay, then first is positive present, second is negative present. Then first we have taken positive WS, then taken negative. Okay. Then both values are put here, that is YWT plus WS plus sigma WS minus WS. Okay, then in which we have taken the common is WS, that is 1 minus sigma WS, but WT plus WS, this is the formula for YS. YS is equal to WT plus WS, then put YS as it is plus 1 minus sigma WS. Okay, now this is the formula for YS dash is equal to YS plus 1 minus sigma for WS. Okay. Then minus sign is taken outside, that is YS dash is equal to YS minus 1 plus sigma into WS. Now YS dash as it is, YS as it is. Now 1 plus sigma is called as gap coefficient, that is called as Carter gap coefficient between stator and rotor. And this Carter gap coefficient is depends on reluctance, that is called as KCS. Okay, now this is the important point, is Carter gap coefficient is depends on reluctance of air gap. Okay, that means in which we have to need first find out slot pitch and again find out slot pitch for YS dash. Okay, now this is the important formula for slot pitch. Okay, then also Carter coefficient is depends on slot, number of slot. Okay, and also Carter's coefficient is depends on type of the slot. Okay, that means in Carter coefficient, semi enclosed slot is used, then it gives better efficiency as compared to the open slot. That means we have shown the two slot, is semi and open. Okay, now this is the relation between semi and open, and both are using Carter gap coefficient. Then also in which we have to calculate reluctance of air gap. Okay, same procedure is reluctance of air gap, SG is equal to LG upon mu 0 A. Then area is YS dash into L. YS dash means slot pitch, it is LG upon mu 0 into YS dash into L. But also we have to calculate the value of YS dash is here. Okay, this value use here. Then this value put in YS dash. Okay. Then SG is equal to LG upon mu 0. Then value of YS put here, YS minus KCS into WS into L. Okay. Also in this formula of the reluctance of air gap, is totally depends on slot. Okay, number of slot, and also number of slot depends on reluctance of smooth armature. That means reluctance of air gap is always depends on reluctance of armature. And this ratio is called as gap contraction factor. That is called as KGS. Okay. Now this is the relation between reluctance of air gap with respect to reluctance of armature. That is called as KGS. Then also we have to need formula for KCS and KGS. This is the formula for KCS with respect to slot pitch. Then we have to need to find out gap contraction factor. Okay. Then gap contraction factor formula is depends on this condition. Okay. Now this is the air gap section. These are the tooth are present. Okay. And this is the duct portion. That means gap between two slot. That is called as width of duct. W A means width of duct portion. Also, the width of duct portion is also depends on axial length of machine. Then we have to calculate L dash. This is the axial length. Okay. L means axial length. Then we have to calculate L dash is equal to, that is called as effective axial length. L dash is equal to L minus KCD ND into WD. KCD means Carter coefficient for duct portion. ND means number of ducts. That is the, these are the first duct portion. This is the second duct portion. Okay. Then WD means width of duct portion. Okay. Then find out the gap contraction factor for slot. KGD is equal to L upon L minus KCD into ND into WD. And all the symbol is depends on length of air gap. That is L. Okay. Then also in which we have to need to find out gap contraction factor, and gap contraction factor depends on duct portion. And two duct portions are shown in, and also duct portion is also depends on width of duct portion. That means duct portion is very important in stator and rotor to find out the effective axial length of the induction motor. In all parameters, there is all parameter will be confusing because in which we have to use large number of symbols, and large number of symbol is defined for stator and rotor, then stator teeth, rotor teeth, then stator core and rotor core. Then this all symbol is very complicated to understand. Then I request all students, these all notes will be write in own notes for understanding, because all symbol is very confusing for unit number 6 for the performance parameter of the three phase induction motor. And this all symbol is very important because each and every symbol using this unit is its meaning is very different. From that means symbol is very important because symbol always says their own explanation or own meaning. The symbol is very important for unit number 6. Symbol is, it gives exact working of the parameter. Okay, that means stator and rotor section is very complicated in induction motor because large amount of symbols used in stator and rotor, and it is very confusing part in unit number 6. Okay, then I have already covered all the symbols and all the notes. Unit number 6. There is a no need for another note. Okay. Then these are the several parameters, and also I have explained all parameters with their explanation, and also all diagram will be present in unit number 6. Okay. There is a no need for other notes. Okay. Also all point will be covered. Also all symbols and their explanation also covered. That is magnetizing current, core loss component. Okay. And these are the important parameters for stator and rotor. Okay. Now these are the several parameters very important in unit number 6. Okay. it is very difficult to understand, but all parameters will be simple in stator and rotor because its symbol is very important for understanding. Okay, now also this is the effect of duct portion, depends on magnetizing current. Okay. Also saturation graph, then reluctance of air gap is very important there. Also axial portion, then Cartel's coefficient depends on stator slot and rotor slot. This is the formula for gap contraction factor. Okay. Only 3 points are pending in unit number 6, that is leakage, flux and their expression, then losses of three-phase induction motor and different types of flux. That means types of flux, that is leakage flux, that is zigzag flux, overtap flux and overhang flux. These 3 points will be covered in next lecture. Okay.